Before we move on any further, we need to understand the meaning of the word ilah. La ilah. The word ilah. What does the word ilah mean in the Arabic language? The word ilah in the Arabic language means ma'bud, worship. Ma'bud, the meaning of the word ilah means ma'bud. This is what the word ilah means in the Arabic language. Regardless of whether that which is worshipped in truth or in falsehood. So anything or anyone that is worshipped is known as ilah. This is in agreement with the great scholars such as Imam Ibn Jarir, who was a mufassir as well as a alim of the Arabic language. Ibn Sayyida, Ibn Faris, these are great linguists of the Arabic language. They are all in agreement that the word ilah ma'nahu ma'bud, as Ibn Jarir al-Tabari mentions. Al-Imam al-Mu'allimi al-Yamani rahmatullah alayh, one of the great scholars, the Zahabi of this time, he says that ignorance in understanding what the word ilah means necessitates ignorance in understanding tawheed. So if you do not know the meaning of la ilaha illallah and ilah, this necessitates that you cannot understand the tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So there is ijma amongst the scholars of the Arabic language as well as the mufassirun that the word ilah in the Arabic language means ma'bud. Now the word ilah has been derived from the root word of alaha ya'luhu, ala wazni abada ya'budu, on the measurement of fi'al, ala wazni fi'al, bima'na maf'ul, meaning the object. Object meaning, if you were to say Muhammad ate the apple, Muhammad is the subject, the fa'al. Eating, the ate is the fa'al, and the apple is the object, the maf'ul. So the word ila ala wazni fi'al is, it means the one that is worshipped, ma'bud. And the word ila, its plural is aliha. One of the plurals of the jam of the word ilah is aliha uluha wal ilaha. These are the plurals for the word ilah. As we know that we start with the word la ilah. And ilah means ma'bud. So the correct translation for the word ilah is not God, it's ma'bud, which is deity. Which is a deity. So therefore the correct translation of la ilaha is that there is no deity. There is no deity. Deity is that is worshipped. We'll come to the issue of using the word God, when it is permissible to use the word God for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what the scholars, Ahlul Ilm, they say with regards to using the word God for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the correct translation of la ilaha illallah is that there is no deity worthy of worship in truth except Allah. La ma'buda bihaqqin illallah. As Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah believe that the meaning of la ilaha illallah is la ma'buda bihaqq. There is no deity worthy of worship in truth except Allah. Whereas some people of bid'ah, ahlul bid'ah, they say la mawjuda illallah, that nothing exists except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is batil. So in reality they say everything that is worshipped and everything that exists is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And from there you get the understanding of this translation that there is no God but Allah, meaning that everything that is worshipped is like it is Allah. As nafi and nafi, negative plus negative, equals ithbat, positive. So we understand from this that the word ilah. So the word ilah in the Arabic language is as they say, min asma'il ajnas. Meaning, what does this mean? That it is from the asma'il ajnas, as the scholar As-Suwaydi said. It means that the original meaning is that every deity that is worshipped in truth or falsehood is called an ilah. Alaykum as-salam. Al-Baydawi, another great scholar, he mentions when he explains what the word ilah means. He says that the word ilah originally means a deity. Then the meaning deity worthy of worship in truth became apparently used. So the word ilah in its original form means that which is worshipped, a deity. And then it became used as la ma'buda bihaq. Only refers to who? To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The word ilah in general is anything that is worshipped. Then it became specifically for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which means that deity that is worshipped in truth. And that is only who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the great scholars states with regards to the word ilah, if it is argued, if the meaning of the word ilah means ma'bud, deity, is it then permissible to say, based upon this, that we call everything that is worshipped ilah? So his question, he said that if we understand that the word ilah comprises of two meanings, one is everything that is worshipped, and the other is the one that is worshipped in truth. So he says that if we are to say, then is it permissible to say, based upon this, that we can call everything that is worshipped an ilah, as we say ma'bud, for the one worship? And he responds his wife by saying that this in reality is not permissible, because the real meaning of the word ilah is dhul uluhiyya, which means the one that is mustahaq lil uluhiyya wal ibadah, the one that is worthy of being worshipped, and that is who? Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is dhul uluhiyya. So therefore al ilah, after understanding all this, we can understand that ilah is referring to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In this phrase, la ilaha illallah. And how do we know that it is referring to ilah, is referring to Allah? Because it says, illallah. Allah. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in conclusion, with regards to this word ilah, many of you are thinking that so much detailed and so much information can be given in such a word, ilah. The ulama have written so much, hundreds of pages on this. In a nutshell or in conclusion, we say that everything that is worshipped other than Allah is an ilah in its linguistic sense, on the basis that it is worshipped. Although in reality, they are not worthy of being worshipped. They are known as aliha, but they are known as alihatun batila. Those deities that are worshipped upon false, not upon, based upon truth. So if there is an ilah which is worthy of being worshipped in truth, then who is that? That is only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this attribute for them is established from a perspective. When we call these other deities aliha or ilah, when we say that this is an ilah of the Hindus, or the ilah of the Jews, or the ilah of the Christians, or the ilah of the pagans, we attribute this from a perspective and negate it from a perspective. We established that min jihat al-waqi', that in reality, that is which is the reality, these deities are worshipped, although they are not being worthy of being worshipped. And as min jihat al-istihqaq, that in terms of them being worthy, then only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is worthy of being worshipped. So therefore the word ilah means ma'buda bihaq, dhul uluhiyya, al-mustahaq lil-ibadah wal-uluhiyya. and that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, Imam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he states, he says, it is not intended with the word ilah that anyone who worships that is not worthy as such deities are many. Although they have been called deities, although they have been called aliha, which has been narrated regarding them, but to have taken them as deities is batil. Although they have been called aliha and god deities, the reality is that there is only one true deity worthy of worship, and that is who? That is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So going into length and with regards to this discussion, we come to the conclusion that the word ilah, as mentioned here, this constant in the context of the shahada, is referring to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Although the word ilah has been used for other deities, it has only been used from the perspective that it is a reality. It is batil, but the people worship other deities, although these deities are not worthy of being worshipped.